Everyone, how are you? I hope you're doing well. Thank you for joining me for another reading. It is Friday night, and the awards that they shot tonight, Friday night, will be streamed tomorrow for the public to see over Saturday and Sunday. So that'll be exciting to watch. I watched as much live footage as I could today, and Princess Catherine looks stunning. Oh my goodness, her necklace was gorgeous. She's gorgeous and she's just so kind. She illuminates kindness and goodness, and it's just, you can just tell she's a good soul. Which brings me to my next point. Obviously, there are forces at work here. There is evil and there is goodness. And Prince William and Princess Catherine are the good forces in the world. And then there are also evil forces in the world. Some of it is shocking, completely shocking that some of these things have occurred during the time of their visit here, their royal visit here in the United States. Whether Meghan and Harry knew or not that Netflix was going to do this, the timing is terrible. And Prince William and Princess Catherine's visit has been known since months and months in advance. All right. Cards, please tell me, was there intention behind releasing the Netflix trailer of Meghan and Harry's quote-unquote love story during the royal visit? So that's Seven of Wands reversed. Page of Wands upright. Yeah, so there's definitely a competitive energy here coming from Meghan and Harry. This is undeniable. That is the Nine of Pentacles. Yeah, of course, their intention is money. Of course, their intention is to make money, to promote themselves. This is competition to them. They are feeling like they're being. Meghan and Harry actually are the ones that feel like they are being overshadowed, and this is why they pulled this stunt. They're feeling threatened. These two are being quite ruthless, actually. I don't think that they're actually considering optically how bad this looks. It's like it's quite ruthless, and it's quite like the energy is competitive. Meghan and Harry are the ones that feel threatened at this moment, which is why they've done this. They are definitely trying to ruin. I don't want to single out Kate, but that's what I'm feeling. It's not so much Harry, okay? It's Meghan. She does want to hurt Kate's image because the Empress card is upright. This to me represents Kate in this instance. And then the King of Swords represents selfishness. So these are done with impure intentions. It's done to harm and hurt, to intentionally ruin the reputation of a certain someone, and I believe it's Kate in this reading. So Ace of Wands is reversed. Okay, so it's like yeah, it's The way they feel is very fiercely competitive, feeling like Princess Catherine and Prince William are stealing their shine, stealing their thunder. They're thinking, well, this is supposed to be our time. This is supposed to be our shine. We're the ones that are supposed to be, in the limelight. And they really don't like that these two are in the limelight right now. They really don't like it. This is Seven of Pentacles. Yeah, this is definitely done for the purpose of, their millions. This is a marketing ploy. This is for money, money, money. The Fool's reversed. I would say this is Prince Harry in this case, and he's probably looking at this like it is a bad idea. He's probably the only one out of the two in this equation that has any type of hesitation or feeling like this is perhaps not the best idea. So we'll give him that, but at the same time, he's still going along with it willingly. And to me, that's equally as bad. So the Five of Swords, so both of them feel defeated. Meghan and Harry feel like they have to up the ante a bit because they feel defeated. With Princess Catherine and Prince William being in the United States, they really feel deflated. It's like they're trying to up the ante, if that makes any sense. They're doing what they can, and you'll see her. You saw her release a picture of her son, which she never did before. It's supposed to add shock value, and that's why I always thought she was using her children for monetary gain. That was it, for monetary gain. I always thought she held out from giving anybody pictures of her children was because she was waiting for the highest bidder. And she quickly found out that nobody was bidding. Nobody cared. Nobody wanted pictures of her children. And so now that she is finding herself in a position where she has to up the ante, she will show her children's pictures because nobody else was interested, so she might as well use it now for the big marketing ploy, which is quite disgusting, actually. Meghan and Harry certainly knew that Prince William and Princess Catherine were going to be in the United States months before they arrived. So this is not shocking news. I'm sure they relayed this to Netflix somehow, some way. So I really don't buy it that there wasn't any intention behind this. Take that as you will. Okay, now I'd like to do a reading on the Earthshot prize. I just want the overall energy of tonight. I know I'm gonna get good cards because it's William and Catherine, of course. They exude positive energy. This is the reading that I was looking forward to the most. I just love that they're here, and I'm kind of sad that they're leaving so soon. 3 days, it doesn't seem like a very long time. And it was freezing cold throughout their visit. I hope they enjoyed their stay. So, just want the overall energy of the Earthshot prize, the energy for this evening. I'm sure it was electric and positive and nothing but positivity and encouragement. I just love what they're doing. I love their initiative. Yeah, so Prince William wants to leave a legacy. This is a project that's near and dear to his heart, and he wants to leave a legacy for his children, for the children of the future. It's about new beginnings. Prince William and Princess Catherine are trying to establish good relations with the United States. Anything that was fractured before, he wants that, you know, he wants it to be a good new beginning, and he wants to set roots down for his children as well. This is a legacy project for him. He wants his children to continue this. He wants to make the right decision. He wants to stand up for this initiative. He wants the initiative to be clear, and anything that this initiative wants or needs, he wants to provide it. He wants to make sure it has two legs to stand on. This is his project. This is his achievement. This is something him and Princess Catherine are trying to accomplish together. This is a sense of completion for him and Catherine that they're doing together, that they are setting down roots in the United States. So this is something that's very, very important to him on a world level. This is like big, big stuff. The president went to go see him and Catherine. So this is very impactful and important initiatives that he is bringing forth to the world. Another ace card. This is the Ace of Wands. Similar to this, new beginnings, starting something new. This is his project, his creative initiative. It's his passion. His passion. This is his hard work, and Catherine's hard work paying off. This is what he was born to do. He's born to be a leader, and he's born to perform duties and make a change in the world. This is his hard work paying off. And I think it's something he's been planning or thinking of for a very long time, and it's finally come to life. So good for him. Good for him and Catherine. Yay! Good reading. Two ace cards. So last question. Will Meghan and Harry attend the Ripple of Hope Awards? Will Meghan and Harry attend the Ripple of Hope Awards? I mean, while Prince Philip laid on his deathbed, Prince Harry and Meghan still did the interview with Oprah Winfrey. So what is stopping them now? What's to say they won't attend the Ripple of Hope Awards? I mean, I feel like since that last reading we did, where it seemed like they were scared that Princess Catherine and Prince William were stealing their shine, that this is something that they would probably want to go to get their shine back. However, I think that they're making a grave mistake if they go. Optics of it looks terrible. And I believe Alex Baldwin will be hosting this, and he's got his own issues. You don't know who Alec Baldwin is to my non-American viewers. He's an actor who's in a lot of hot water for shooting somebody on a movie set that he was on. The director, I believe her first name is Helena. I'm sorry, I don't know her last name. Yeah, and she unfortunately passed away, and Alec Baldwin is been doing interviews after her death, and I think that's just totally uncalled for. Not only is he doing them, he's looking terrible in these interviews. He's saying all the wrong things. He should just shut up. He should let his lawyers do the talking, but he's a little too arrogant. So anyways, he's going to be the host of this Ripple of Hope Awards. And also, So Caroline Kennedy was the ambassador for the Earthshot Prize for Prince William and Princess Catherine, but I forget which Kennedy, but they're going to be presenting the Ripple of Hope Award to Meghan and Harry if they go. So it's kind of an awkward thing to be going to this Ripple of Hope Award, receiving it from a Kennedy, and yet another Kennedy was also at the Earthshot Award. It's just, oh, this is just so messed up. So, question to the cards. Will Meghan and Harry attend the Ripple of Hope Awards? Yeah, it looks like they will. Oh my goodness. So this is the Seven of Wands. It's kind of part about like standing your ground and standing for what you believe in, fighting for your beliefs. You know, this is kind of defensive energy. And since they feel like they're being attacked or their shine is being taken away, it looks like, yeah, they will be attending, but we'll see. Two of Cups reversed. Wow. So it doesn't look like they are in agreement of attending this, though. I think one of them is adamant, like pretty darn adamant about going, and one of them has reservations. So I'm gonna guess that it's Harry that has reservations and Meghan is the one that wants to go. Just based off their personality and also by what I feel. So if they do go, I think it's just gonna be, I don't know. If he does go, if Prince Harry does go, he's not gonna, it's not because he wants to. It doesn't look like he wants to. But he'll go because she's going. Yeah, she's going to be the one that she's the one in charge. So whether he wants to go or not, he's going. Optically, this is gonna look terrible, though. This is gonna look terrible. And I think he knows that. Yeah, he knows that. He knows it's gonna look bad. He's got anxiety about it. I think he's torn. I think he does not. I'm not sure if he really wants to go. Because he himself actually feels like it would be fake to accept this award. He knows this. I feel like he knows this. But if he does go, it's because she's forcing him to. She's forcing him to. She's being aggressive. And she wants to, she's talking about like standing her ground and not giving in. She wants and fighting for what you believe in. She's going to coax him with this type of language. We need to stand up for what we believe in. We've come this far. We need to keep going. You know, all that crap that gets him in trouble. This would be not only optically bad, this could possibly affect them financially too. Because brands are not going to want to associate with them. Once they see that they are associated with this award ceremony, something about this ceremony is not going to end well if they attend. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I think they're definitely going. She definitely has it out for the royal family. This is the Hierophant reverse, which is challenging tradition. She definitely has it out for the royal family. She doesn't believe in the monarchy. She never wanted to conform. She doesn't believe in tradition. She's really out. I don't know how many times we've seen the Hierophant reverse. She is really out to get the monarchy. So, in my opinion, unless something drastic occurs and makes them change their mind, it really does look like they're going. And it's gonna cost them. It's gonna cost them if they go. I don't think any brands are gonna want to associate with them after this. I have really been enjoying watching videos of Prince William and Princess Catherine in New England, and they are just so beautiful. Like they are such a beautiful couple, and they're so inspiring, and they're so kind. I can't stress enough how beautiful of a couple they are. There will be a lot to talk about in the near future. I feel like there's a lot coming up. Thank you so much for joining me, and I will see you next time. Take care. Bye, guys.
Living like a fairy tale. We could have a palace right in the